Hello everyone, in this video I would like to show you how to make these beautiful fractal trees in GeoGebra. As you can appreciate in this animation, they look quite complex, but in fact they can be constructed using some basic geometric transformations, recursions, plus a little bit of randomness. Let's begin with the most basic example of a fractal tree. We start with a segment defined from point A to point B. Then we create two branches based on this segment. To create the first branch, we define a new segment by rotating the original segment with respect to point B using a particular angle. In this case, I use 5, pi, and 4, and shrinking it by a given factor, which is 3 and 4 in this case, or 0.75. The second branch is then created in a similar way, but rotating the original segment with a different angle. Now I used 3, pi, and 4, so it looks symmetrical, and we use the same shrinking factor, 0.75. Then we repeat the same process for each one of the branches to obtain 4 new branches, and so on. And we can continue as many times as we wish. But we're going to stop in this one. The steps to create this basic example are essentially 3. Number 1, create the segment and 2 branches. Number 2, create a new tool. And number 3, iterate. That is, we repeat the same process over and over again. Now let me show you how to do this in GeoGebra. We're going to work with GeoGebra Classic 5 for desktop, but you can also use the GeoGebra Classic 6 online. The method that I'm going to show you here works for both versions of GeoGebra, since I will be using the GeoGebra scripting commands. If you have never used GeoGebra before, don't worry, you still can follow this tutorial to create fractal trees and have some fun. Step number 1, here we're going to create a segment and 2 branches. To start, we click and hold for a second on the slider tool, that is the second icon from the right to the left. This will show the list of tools available, and we are going to select the tool button. Then we click on the graphics view to create a button, and the following window will pop up. And here we're going to type some GeoGebra commands. This technique is known as scripting, and is incredibly useful to create applets in GeoGebra. In the caption input box, I like to type setup, but you can use any other caption. Here I already have the GeoGebra script. Essentially, this is a sequence of commands that are going to be executed one after each other. For example, in line number 1, this indicates that we are going to create a segment from point 0,0 to point 0,2. Lines 3 and 4 create points A and B using the command point. Notice I used also a parameter in each case, 0 and 1 respectively. This will define both points as the endpoints of my segment F. In lines 6 and 7, we create points C and D to draw my branches. Here is where I apply the rotation and dilation of the angles that I mentioned before, 5 pi and 4, 3 pi and 4, and the shrinking factor 0.75. Finally, I define the list output as a list containing the 2 branches. Then we click on OK, and the button now will be available in the graphics view, as you can appreciate here. To run the script inside the button, first we must select the command move, which is located on the left side, is the first icon. Then click on the setup button, and after clicking you will see our segment with the 2 branches, as you can appreciate here. So in step 2, we're going to create our new tool. To create a new tool in GeoGebra, in the main menu at the top, look for Tools and click on Create New Tool. On the pop-up window, in the tab Output Object, select List Output and then click on Next. Then in the Input Objects tab, select Original Segment F, click on Next. Then in the name and icon tab, you have to input the name of the tool. In this case, I type grow with capital G and click on finish to create your new tool. you will see this new window popping up, and it indicates that you have created successfully your tool. And that's it, we can now use our new tool. Notice that we just created a personalized tool, and the icon will show up right next to the predefined GeoGebra tools. We can use this new tool by clicking on it and selecting a segment to create its branches, or we can also use it as a command in the input box. This is a very useful method to create personalized tools, so you're not limited by the predefined tools in GeoGebra. Now in our step number 3, we're going to apply our iteration. Now that we have our personalized tool named Row, we can use it in combination with other GeoGebra commands to create our fractal tree. First of all, we have the iteration list command, and then the flatten command, and finally the zip command. The first command, the iteration list, is going to be our main command, and the other two are going to be auxiliary commands. So the full instruction that includes our personalized tool named Grow is here. We type this code in the input box in GeoGebra and hit enter to obtain our fractal tree. I know this code looks quite intimidating, so let's break it up and to understand what is going on. The zip command creates a list of branches using our tool grow with a variable s that belongs to a list, in this case is named label. Then the flatten command, as it says, it flattens a list to one single list. Finally, the iteration list command, we have to input our expression that defines the tree. The variable in this case is a list of branches, and we have to input the start value, in this case our original segment f, and finally the counts, that is the number of iterations. As a next step, to make our fractal tree a little bit more interesting, we can add some colors and modify the thickness at each level. Again, this can be done easily using GeoGebra scripting. I'm not going to discuss the details about this here, but you can check the link in the description for this extra step. In the previous example, we started with a segment and two branches, using fixed values for rotation and dilation. We can replace these fixed values for parameters, for example, and vary them to see what happens. And here, for example, I replace the fixed values for sliders, so we can easily change them and play around to see what happens. In our basic example, we use the angles 5π and 4 and 3π and 4 and the same dilation factor 0.75. Now let's see what happens when we replace those values with the following. In this case, we introduce the command random, which gives a random number between 0 and 1. So when we multiply by pi on 4, we obtain a value between 0 and pi on 4 in the first case. The result is shown here. Note that the branches are different every time I update the construction. To make things even more interesting, we can add an extra branch randomly by including in our list output the following code. This creates a new branch if the value random is greater than 0.7. The new branch is defined with another point, which is obtained by rotating point A with a random angle and shrinking it a random factor with respect to point B as well. By the way, I have chosen these values arbitrarily. You can use other random numbers if you prefer and see what happens. On the other hand, if random is less than or equal to 0.7, then it creates a single point, since the command segment from B to B defines only a point, or a segment of length 0. As a result, we obtain this new construction where the two branches will show up, and sometimes I will have three branches randomly every time I refresh the construction. We can follow the same steps as we did in our basic example to create more amazing fractal trees. That is, create a segment and branches, create new tools, and finally iterate. Also, as we did in our basic example, we can modify the thickness and change the color. The results are outstanding, as you can see here. Now you may like to create your own fractal trees by using different random values or maybe plotting more branches randomly. If you get stuck, don't worry, there are links in the description below with full instructions and online demos that you can reuse and adapt. There is also a link to a GeoGebra activity where you can create and download a randomly generated tree. Have fun and thanks for watching.